It's winter in Ankara and there is a lot of snow. Ankara is not only the capital of Turkey, it's also home to the military headquarters. And I've asked the army to give me an interview so I could ask them several questions. Most importantly, why they think homosexual men are unfit to do military service. But they refused my request. So instead, I've organized an interview with a retired general. His name is Armağan Kuloğlu, who now works here in a think tank. Why is there no place for gay people in the Turkish army?
Ordu içerisinde eşcinsel olanların hizmet yapmasını bir takım...
There are problems with gays serving in the army. Firstly, there's an issue of discipline. Whether it be in the dormitories, in the canteen, in training, or in bathrooms, soldiers are always together in groups, where friendship, solidarity, and teamwork come into play. But if gays are also allowed, extra measures would have to be taken. Separate facilities would need to be created.
General Kuloğlu defends the system of identifying who is gay and who is not.
Kendisinin eşcinsel olduğunu beyan etmez ise.
If a gay man does not declare himself gay and his behavior does not give the impression that he is homosexual, then he can do his military service as long as he does not raise suspicions. But when someone comes out and says he's gay, then there's the possibility that he's just pretending in order to evade his military service. In order to eliminate suspicions like these, he's required to be examined and tested.
I have spoken to some gay men who have told me that they had really degrading treatment by the military officials. When they declared themselves gay, they had to provide proof of photographs. They were asked very invasive questions and so on and so forth. What do you think about the examination process in the military hospitals?
Biraz önce de ifade ettiğim gibi, acaba askerlik hizmetini yapmamak
için... The army needs to know whether the applicant is lying when he says he's gay to evade military service, or whether he is truly gay. But the army headquarters has said clearly no photographs are demanded. There is only a medical examination and some psychological tests to determine homosexuality. I have to stress, the army does not regard homosexuality as an illness, but as a behavioral issue, a sexual preference. But such people may cause disciplinary problems while serving in the army, so they are banned.
We've just heard General Kuloğlu say that the army doesn't use photographic evidence. But I have heard from gay men who say they were asked to provide photographs as recently as last year. He also says that the army doesn't treat homosexuality as an illness. Well, actually, it does. It uses the 1968 version of a document of the American Psychiatric Association that categorizes homosexuality as a mental disorder. So, while the world has moved on in its evaluation of homosexuality, Turkey hasn't. And this creates enormous problems for military psychiatrists.
Military psychiatrists in Turkey, they are reluctant to talk about this issue in public, and not least because it's a criminal offense in Turkey to undermine the military in the public eye and to disclose military information to the outside world. So the psychiatrist that I'm meeting now, who has spent some time in a military hospital, insisted that I don't reveal his name.
There is no specific sign for being a homosexual. So the military professionals are probably anxious that they may be cheated. So they need some proof. That's why sometimes, not because they are homophobic, with a big mistake, actually, they are asking for that proof. Because if you are going to take a report that you are homosexual and you are not, you can't be serving in the military, then you get married 2 or 3 years later. Then the psychiatrist will be in trouble. So the psychiatrist is trying to be confident about that. But it's a wrong way, and it's not working.
The psychiatrist, their motivation, is it the fear from their senior commanders, or is this simply cruelty?
I don't think the psychiatrists are to blame in this. I mean, the problem is someone higher than the doctors should be deciding whether they are taking homosexuals to the army or not. But it's the doctors who need to decide whether someone is homosexual or not, which is impossible medically and ethically. It's impossible.
Basically, this is all pseudoscience.
Yeah, probably. Homosexuality is not a disorder. So if you are asking a doctor to diagnose something which is not a disorder itself, so if you don't have any diagnostic tools, and in a military service where you have to obey the rules, and you are asked to do something, these are some desperate attempts to file in about sexual orientation of the people who are claiming to be homosexual, but it's not scientifically true, it's not ethical at all, and it's not working.
Another point of confusion has to do with a very particular understanding of homosexuality in the Turkish army.
If you are caught during sexual intercourse in the military service, you will be exempt from military service and you will get a report on psychosexual disorder if you are in the bottom position.
If you are the passive partner.
Yeah, if you are the passive partner. But if you are active, then you will be serving still, but you will have a big punishment. The army thinks that the passive position is a disorder itself. The active position is some behavior to be punished, but it's not a disorder.
Some people in Turkey believe gay men are lucky, since they are given an option to get out of military service, which means they don't have to spend months in the barracks or face the possibility of being deployed to fight against Kurdish militants. But for gay men, it is not that simple. In Turkey, there can be long-term consequences of disclosing your homosexuality to the army.
Gökhan, has your exemption from the military had any effect on your professional life?
Well, some employers ask if you have completed your military service, especially big firms, big factories, human resources department, they ask this. When they ask, I say I am exempted, and they don't call me back. At one place, factory that I worked, I gave them everything except the military sheet.
The form that shows that you have done your military service?
Yes, and they asked for maybe 6-7 times, bring it, bring it, bring it. I didn't bring it, and I didn't say I won't bring. After that, my boss went to the army and learned that I am exempted. And on the exemption sheet, it writes psychosexual disorder, and in parenthesis, homosexuality. And after that, the way they behaved me changed.
The way they treated you changed.
Yes, yes. They behaved badly.
As for Ahmet, the one who refused to dress up as a woman, the humiliation is going to be drawn out. He's still waiting to hear whether he'll have to do military service.
Ben, olabildiği kadar zarar görmedim.
I want to get this whole process over and done with as soon as possible. But I'm not going to get a decision about whether I have to do military service for another 6 or 7 months. Then I'm hoping to move abroad and live there.
So you plan to go abroad. You're hoping to live elsewhere. Why?
Çünkü bu bir damga gibi.
It feels like they're putting a mark on me. I don't want to live in a state that keeps official documents about my sexuality, one that registers me as a gay man. I love this country, but I don't want to live through more difficulties in the future. I plan to go abroad as soon as I can.
Back at the bus terminal, for the new recruits, the journey is about to start.
The friends of the new conscripts, they just sang the national anthem and they were lighting firecrackers and they stopped the bus actually and they are not letting the bus go. There's a huge crowd now right in front of the bus and it's just going centimeter by centimeter and now finally they've let it go and they are banging on the bus saying goodbye to their friends. The new conscript heads off to the barracks.
There are dozens of different podcasts now available from the BBC, including news, documentaries, science, business, arts and sport. The details of them all go to bbcworldservice.com/podcasts.